हेलो एंड वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, इट्स नाज़िया बेगम हियर, योर फिजिक्स लेक्चरर। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द टॉपिक सेंट्रिपिटल एक्सेलरेशन। इन आर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट एंगुलर एक्सेलरेशन इन यूनिफॉर्म सर्कुलर मोशन। द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेलोसिटी डज नॉट चेंज, बट बिकॉज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ वेलोसिटी चेंजेस कंटिन्यूसली, that's why they are produce some acceleration and that is called the angular acceleration. Okay, now one new term here is that centripetal acceleration. So what is centripetal acceleration? See, whatever acceleration is produced in uniform circular motion, the direction of that acceleration is towards the center of the circle. Okay, in whatever circle the particle is moving, the acceleration has the direction towards the center of that circle, and that's why it is called as centripetal acceleration. And because this acceleration is produced by change in direction, that's why direction plays very important role here, and it is given a name according to direction only. Because the direction is towards center, that's why it is called centripetal acceleration. As shown in this diagram, consider a particle is moving in a circular path, okay, of radius r with a constant speed v, and it travels from point A to point B along the circumference, okay, along this circle. And from A to B, okay, when the particle moves from A to B, suppose it took time del t. And one more thing is there, that if we want to find out the direction of velocity of the moving particle at any particular point, so what we do, we simply draw one tangent here. The direction of tangent shows us the direction of the particle in uniform circular motion. So when the particle is at A, this tangent is showing its direction of velocity. When the particle is at B, this tangent is showing its direction of velocity. Okay, so here you can see this is the direction of velocity. So the particle should move in this direction. Okay, but particle is not going forward here, but it is moving in this direction. Are you understanding this? This is the direction of velocity, but particle is not going in this direction, but it is moving in this direction. Okay, similarly here, this is the direction of motion of particle, but particle, instead going in this direction, it moves in this direction. So why that change in direction is there? It is because the direction of acceleration is towards the center. Okay, and that's why the particle also tries to move towards the center. So this is the direction of velocity. The particle should move in this direction, but because of centripetal acceleration, particle moves towards center. Okay, here it is moving towards center, but instead of going in center, like it is not moving like this, instead of going in center, it moves this side, because at this point this will be the direction of velocity. Okay, here if you draw one tangent at this point, we will get this direction of velocity. So now again the particle is not going here, but bent this side. Then at this point, this is the direction of velocity, but particle is not going here, but bent this side. So you can see here, at every point the particle is being deflected towards the original direction of velocity. Okay, and it is trying to move towards the center, and that's why we can say that acceleration here is directed towards the center, and that acceleration only is trying to move the particle also towards the center. but because the direction of velocity is given by a tangent, that's why particle is not going inside the center but moving in a circular motion. I hope now you all have understood that how the direction of acceleration is towards center. Okay, that is clear to you all. Now this is the arc traveled by the particle from A to B. Okay, if we want to find out the linear displacement, so this line, this dotted line is showing the linear displacement here. This is the radius vector showing the position of particle at point A. This is the radius vector showing the particle, so position of particle at point B, and between them this is angle theta. This is the angular displacement of the particle in time del t, and this is the linear displacement. Okay, and from the triangular law of vector addition we can see that this is one vector, this is another vector, and when we draw this line, this linear displacement, so this become one complete triangle. So here we can now apply the triangular law. Okay, now similar to this we have drawn one figure here. Okay, so this point A dash is showing O. Okay, here it clearly that which point is showing which point. So O here is represented by A dash. Okay, this point A is shown by B dash. Point B is shown by C dash. So this R position vector, sorry, radius vector R, here one R is there, here one R is there. Okay, here actually they are showing the position, but if you want to show the velocity, okay, so here you can see, okay, let's forget this one, see about the velocity. This is the direction of velocity here and this is the direction of velocity here. So if we have to draw the direction, we can draw it like this. This is v1 and this is v2. Are you understanding? This, if we extrapolate, so it will go straight like this. So this v1, this direction is shown by this, and v2 is going like this in left hand side direction. So this v2 is shown by this. Okay, so this vector is showing v1, this vector is showing v2, and the difference between them is del v. Okay, so now the vectors at point A and B are shown by this diagram, and the positions and displacement is shown by this diagram. Okay, v2 here is equals to v1 plus del v. Why? You can see the direction of v1 and del v is same, and v2 is in opposite direction. So the side of triangle which is in opposite direction is the resultant of addition of these two. So that's why v2 equals to v1 plus del v, or we can write del v equals to v2 minus v1. So this part B dash C dash, it is showing us the change in velocity at time del t. And whatever angle is made here, del theta, same angle will be here, del theta. Okay, so between R and R and between V1 and V2, what is the angular displacement? It is del theta. Now, since the particle is moving with uniform velocity, that's why V1 and V2, they both are same. So here, when we take out its mod, V1 and V2, we can call it as V. Okay, but the direction of V1 and V2 is different. Now, triangle OAB and triangle A dash, B dash, C dash. Okay, these two triangles are similar. So that's why AB upon OA equals to A dash, B dash upon, sorry, B dash, C dash upon A dash, B dash. This side upon this side will be equal to this side upon this side. Okay, so ए बी अपॉन ओ ए इक्वल्स टू बी डैश सी डैश अपॉन ए डैश बी डैश. नाउ फ्रॉम द फिगर ओनली वी विल पुट ऑल दैट वैल्यूज हियर. सो वी गेट डेल वी आफ्टर रीअरेंजिंग दिस डेल वी इक्वल्स टू डेल एक्स अपॉन वी इन टू वी अपॉन आर. इफ वी डिवाइड डेल टी इन बोथ द साइड्स डेल वी अपॉन डेल टी इक्वल्स टू डेल एक्स अपॉन डेल टी इन टू वी अपॉन आर. इफ टाइम डेल टी टेंस टू जीरो सो इट कैन बी रिटन एज दिस और दिस डी वी अपॉन डी टी इक्वल्स टू वी अपॉन आर डी एक्स अपॉन डी टी. नाउ डी वी अपॉन डी टी इक्वल्स टू ए एंड डी एक्स अपॉन डी टी इक्वल्स टू वी. सो वैन वी पुट द वैल्यूज हियर वी गेट ए इक्वल्स टू वी अपॉन आर इन टू वी और वी स्क्वायर अपॉन आर. देन इट कैन ऑल्सो बी रिटन एज ओमेगा स्क्वायर आर. वी इक्वल्स टू ओमेगा आर वैन वी पुट द वैल्यू हियर इन प्लेस ऑफ वी स्क्वायर वी गेट ओमेगा स्क्वायर आर स्क्वायर अपॉन आर. सो वन आर विल गेट कैंसल एंड वी फाइनली हैव ओमेगा स्क्वायर आर. सो बोथ दीज वैल्यू ऑफ सेंट्रीपिटल एक्सेलरेशन यू शुड रिमेंबर. सो वाइल स्टडिंग दिस टॉपिक वी अंडरस्टूड दैट वाई सेंट्रीपिटल एक्सेलरेशन इज नेम्ड सो एंड ऑल्सो वी हैव डिराइव्ड द इक्वेशन फॉर सेंट्रीपिटल एक्सेलरेशन. नाउ लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस चैप्टर नॉन यूनिफॉर्म सर्क्यूलर मोशन. Consider a particle moving along a circular path of radius r with a variable speed. Since speed is variable, the acceleration has a tangential component. Okay? So here you can see in a circular path, one particle will move and now the direction of acceleration will change. Okay? It is having a tangential path. And it is given by at equals to dv upon dt or we can call it as r into a. Due to change in direction of motion at every point, radial component of acceleration ar will be v square upon r. The resultant acceleration then will be a equals to at plus ar. Okay, so first let's understand what is the tangential component and what is radial component. Okay, so when the particle is at this point, this radius vector is showing the radial acceleration of the particle. And if we draw one tangent here, touching this point, so this tangent will show the tangential component of acceleration. Okay, and because they both are in different direction, so their resultant will be this one, A. According to parallelogram law of vector addition. So the value of mod of A equals to under root AR square plus AT square. If AT equals to 0, then particle has only centripetal acceleration. So it will be in uniform circular motion. And if the radial component AR equals to 0 is AR equals to 0, then particle has only tangential acceleration. So it accelerates along tangent to the circular path. So with that last topic, we have completed chapter 4, motion in plane. Now next chapter, I will start with one fresh new video. So this is it for today's lecture. Because new chapter we will start tomorrow in fresh video. That's why today's video is smaller than other one. Okay. So this is it for today. See you in next lecture. Till then, goodbye. Take care. Do some productive work. And the most important thing, be healthy, be safe.